He said for whole day, and
Yeah.
we are in the Haryanvi dress,
Okay.
and we celebrated with our culture and as well as with the meditation experiences and so many new speakers we launched.
Yeah. No, we are all in the junction of Zooms, madam. We don't know where to go. So many Zoom sessions.
So many Zoom sessions.
Our Patri ji is like sun, and Patri madam is like moon. They are all guiding us where to go, how to go. Yeah.
Sir, we are in live, so can we discuss after the session, sir? We
Yeah.
are going in live, so please,
Sure.
Ravita madam, you can take over the session.
Okay. Say ready when it's ready, Sai, so I can talk.
It is now it is ready. The live has started.
Okay. Namaste. This is Kavita Patlola from Austin, Texas. I welcome you all to the day 12 of Digital Dhyana Swadhyaya Yogam presented by PSSM Global, a great platform on which masters across the globe have been sharing wisdom with all of us. My deepest gratitude to Patriji on this platform. And my guest today is an extraordinary woman, women of substance from Haryana, India. I've often wondered about her as a knowledge seeker who discovered immense knowledge in various platforms and also for her selfless service for years. I was privileged to find out my rendezvous with Dr. Sangeeta Nehra. Dr. Sangeeta Nehra is the director of Ayush Department, Government of Haryana, India, since 2012. Ayush wings in each allopathic civil hospital, at each community health center, and at primary health care units. She specialized in Dravya Guna, yoga and meditation, nutrition and dietetic, Panchakarma, which is five-stage healing process in health sector. She's a gold medalist and bachelor's in Ayurvedic medicine and surgery, and she served HIV patients during her study of MD. She's selfless, she's compassionate, as she practiced Ayurveda and yoga as a medical officer for a very long period in the rural areas of Haryana to provide affordable healthcare in the most remote corners and also to the most vulnerable sections of Indian society. Besides her medical profession, Dr. Sangeeta has always been a keen seeker of knowledge and accomplished many more postgraduate degrees in the field of yoga, meditation, philosophy, bachelor's of law, and postgraduate diplomas in nutrition, dietetic, along with many more certificate courses, dear friends. She provides emotional and spiritual counseling, yoga and meditation counseling, and sessions to groups as well as individuals. She taught Ayurveda, yoga, meditation to more than 1 lakh people living in villages, blocks, and cities. She travels nationally, internationally to deliver lectures on spiritual science, Ayurveda, yoga, and naturopathy. She has authored 4 books, primarily related to Ayurveda and feminine genre, Ahar Hai Aushadh, Ayurveda and Twacha, Ek Swatantra Vichar, and Aurat. And currently, she is working on her 5th and 6th books, which are titled as Prana, One Conscious Breath, and Co-creation Between Nakshatras. She got various awards, including Brahma Vidvarishta Award 2019 by Pyramid Spiritual Societies Movement, Swaminathan Smriti Award 2017, Mahakruna Award 2017, Making India Award, Creativity Award, Award of Excellence for Outstanding Performance, Dedication, and Commitment towards Promotion and Propagation of Naturopathy and yoga, and many more accolades to her credit. The list goes on and on, dear friends. So I take immense pleasure to welcome Dr. Sangeeta Nehraji to discuss the topic, see the world as five-layered cake, and discuss the quantum science of consciousness and its experience by Amit Goswami. Welcome, Dr. Sangeeta Ji. The stage is all yours.
Yeah, thank you, Kavita. And thank you all the masters, and thank you so much that giving me this platform, because Nowadays, the Zoom sessions are going on and very busy schedule in Haryana, because since morning 3:30 we wake up and then we start giving the sessions in Akhanda Dhyan, and so long Zoom sessions are going on, and along with my official job.
Yes.
And now why I have chosen this topic, see the world as a five-layered cake, because it is very close to my heart. When I came into meditation in 2011, when I was just thinking that, okay, the spirituality is something, okay, I know the meditation, and then the meditation, and after that, the vegetarianism and the pyramid power, it's okay. But from beginning to till now, I have experienced so many things in my life. So superficially, when we start doing meditation, we understand, okay, we know that, okay, we are close with our breath, breathe in and breathe out, and you are closing towards yourself, and you can know yourself. Like, so what is self? What is spirit? What is soul? Because there are so many words we use many times in a day. And along with this, we think that, okay, this is matter, this is energy. Simply we say that, and we are getting the information from so many books. But practically, we realize that we are the energy beings. Like in this book, Dr. Amit Goswami says one line, the consciousness is the ground of all beings. He says that the consciousness is the ground of all beings. All beings means the mineral kingdom, beings means the plant kingdom, beings means animal kingdom, beings means human kingdom, and even beings means the astral world also. So the consciousness, how he has explained about the consciousness is like there is a one paper. This paper is the whole consciousness in the whole universe. If we just tear it, like, so it splits into two parts. The same, we come from the consciousness, and then we split into two parts, the subject and the object. So when we split, it maybe become the ego self and the quantum self. So he explained so beautifully, because the same line repeated again and again, the consciousness is the ground of the beings, all beings, and along with the brain matter, he has written that line. So the consciousness is something that the whole part, and out of that, we are extracting something. We are extracting. Like the physical part, mental part, intellectual part, spiritual part. So many things where we are extracting from the consciousness. So in Ayurveda, he has started some lines from the Ayurveda side, because I am also an Ayurveda doctor. So in Ayurveda, it is said that we are made up of Panchma Kosha. Panchma Kosha is the first kosh, is the Annamaya Kosha. Annamaya Kosha means the physical body. Then is the Pranamaya Kosha. Pranamaya Kosha is something, the vital body. Then the Manomaya Kosha. Manomaya Kosha is the mental body. Then Vijnanamaya Kosha. Vijnanamaya Kosha is the intellectual body or the supramental body. And then the Anandamaya Kosha. Anandamaya Kosha is the spiritual body. So from the Upanishad side and then the quantum side, both things parallelly, he just mix up the all Upanishad Vedas line and along with the quantum science. So how he mixed up it, so now I will explain step by step. So first he said that the quantum physics is the physics of possibilities. The second, the very popular line from the Dr. Amit Goswami Sahib. The quantum physics is the physics of possibilities. So the possibilities, the possibility is like I'm appearing in front of you on the Zoom session. Maybe the possibilities were there or not. So these are the possibilities, that possibilities which are unconscious. It is remain at the unconscious level or the unmanifest level. Okay, sometimes we use that the brain is the conscious, the subconscious and the unconscious. But Dr. Amit Goswami explained very beautifully, the unconscious is something, the hidden part of our capability. The hidden part of the capability, how we take out from that our archetypal nature or our the soul nature or our the self nature or our the quantum self. How we take out from that consciousness. So that out of the consciousness, that unmanifested part, which is remained, which is silent, which is hidden. So that is the quantum physics, is the physics of possibilities. The physics of possibility is beyond the time and beyond the space. Beyond the time and beyond the space. It means that part is present here in surrounding, but that part is not visible. Same lines in Ayurveda, if we say that, it is the Purush and the Prakriti. Purush and the Prakriti means the invisible, that universe, when it is manifested and we take the body shape and inside that there is a self, then it is the visible. So visible, we say the Jivatma. So Jivatma may be as a mosquito, Jivatma, as a honeybee, Jivatma. We can say the butterfly, Jivatma, the human beings, Jivatma, the trees or flowers, so many things in all the mineral kingdom, plant kingdom, animal kingdom, human kingdom. So Dr. Amit Goswami says that the quantum physics is the physics of possibilities. Possibilities, now we understand, this is the part that is the unmanifested and the hidden part. So now we start from the beginning. The first part is the physical layer. The physical sheath or the physical layer, he explained, okay, this is the physical layer, it is visible to everyone. But inside what I am thinking, how I am feeling, so it is invisible part. So the first layer is the physical layer, is the layer of the physical experiences. Physical experiences is like something I'm looking somewhere, or something I'm listening, or something I'm tasting something. So I'm experiencing. So I'm experiencing out of the consciousness, whatever I want to experience. So that becomes the subject in the object. The subject is something like the subject is me. And the object is what type of the experience from I want to take from the other side. So the subject and object, when it is mixed up, okay, I am drinking the water and I am drinking the water, I am taking the that experience. So that experience, now it becomes the my, the self part or the ego part, because I'm experiencing the things. So the physical body taking the experiencing through sensing. Because Dr. Amit Goswami has explained each and every word with the practical feeling, with the practical sensing. The physical body is the sensing, like the five senses. We feel that whatever we are looking, whatever we are tasting, whatever we are smelling. So all things are related with the physical layer. And then he explained that the physical experience is divided into the two parts, as I told before, that the subject and the object. So everything, whatever we are experiencing, that is the subject and the object. Subject and object, And he explained that even the brain also, the brain is like the physical part, but along with the mind, this is the vital part, or along with the mind, this is the quantum part. So he explained that, okay, we are living in the physical world, and we, most of the time, we feel that we are the physical bodies. And he explained the Newtonian physics. Newtonian physics, he said that, like, the one-way hierarchy is something, the elementary particle, and then the atoms, and then the molecules, and then the cells and the organs and the complete body. So this is the one-way side. One-way side is, he explained that the upward causation. Upward causation means suppose we start from our journey here, and we just step by step, we cross the 10 kilometers area. This is the one-side journey. But in the quantum science, he said the tangled hierarchy. He used the word the tangled hierarchy. Tangled hierarchy is something he like the stimulus and the responses he has used the words. Tangled hierarchy is something he, whatever the stimulus comes from other side, and how I am responding from that stimulus side. So that is the two-way traffic. Like we are talking now with the Suresh ji. So this is the tangled hierarchy he was remembering, and we are like conversing like the previous our talks when we met. So this is the physical experience we remember in the memory, and then we remember in the memory, and it becomes the experience at the physical level. So this is the physical part, and this is the main physical reality. But the four layers is, the first is the like the pranamaya kosha, and the second is the manomaya kosha, and third is vijnanamaya kosha, and the fourth is the anandamaya kosha. These are all the invisible parts which we can't see directly. We can see indirectly through our actions. We can see indirectly through our behavior. So this behavior or actions, these are the quantum field. So this is the quantum field, like how we understand these are the quantum fields. So now let us jump to the second layer. The second layer is the vital body. It is a very important in meditation, because when we breathe in and breathe out, and when we breathe in and breathe out, so the outer universal prana, we inhale and then we exhale. So through which we inhale and we exhale, through the vital body or through the pranamaya kosha. So the pranamaya kosha is invisible in front of us. Only the physical body is visible. So when we inhale, or sometimes we are thinking, sometimes we are in fear, so we have the different feelings. So that feelings imprints on our pranamaya kosha. That's why Patri sir always says, you do meditation, you just be with your breath, and when you be with your breath, so you clear out your chakra system, and you clear out your all pranamaya kosha, all your subtle channels or your gross channels, you will clear out through your breathing process. So same here, Dr. Amit Goswami also explained that the second layer, the vital body, is very, very important to understand, because it is a bridge between the physical and the mind body. So the two bodies have the one bridge, that is the vital body. So the vital body, what is the vital body inside? The inside is, we say that the vital body is having the feelings. Like whatever the experiencing, we taking from the other side, so we have the feelings. Like in our relationships, like my partner and me, we have no good foundations. Yeah, or we can say that we have not developed the good relationship. So the feelings which I felt, so that feelings imprints me in the vital body. That type of the feelings, if I have, so it affects on my chakras. Sometimes I'm, for example, if somebody is very poor, he has no money for eating food, or he has no money for wearing clothes, and he has also not good relationship. So these type of the feelings, if he has, like, so that feelings imprints in the vital body. So it blocks our chakras. So chakras, he has explained very, very beautifully in this book. So the vital body is rates with our feelings and along with our breathing patterns. Like he explained that one exercise, do be. Like if you are doing any exercise, you are doing any yoga or pranayama or asana. So if you are doing the practices, so first you do this and then you feel that what type of the feelings by doing that exercise, what type of the feelings I am having. So the vital body is important to understand that when the breathing, if we are with our breathing process, like if we do the meditation or sometimes we do the Kapalbhati pranayama and sometimes we do the Bhramari pranayama, Anulom Vilom pranayama. So he explained that it clear out all the subtle channels in the vital body. And when it clear out all the subtle channels, it opens all the chakras. So he explained that in the root chakra. Root chakra like is something, root chakra is related with the physical implications. Like sometimes we have the constipation and because of the fear, because of the stress, because of the anxiety. So how we clear that through the vital body, we can clear out and open the channels of that vital body. So the vital body is something, is the bridge between the physical body and the mental body. So this is the vital body in which we can take the more like part, like the vital energy. Vital energy is something like if we are, I'm practicing some exercise, some pranayama. So if I'm practicing, that vital energy is transferred to the physical body, transferred to the physical organs. Transfer because the physical organs are in the movement. When the physical organs are in the movement, so he used the word like the, if I have like one computer, he has given the example that the hardware and the software. The hardware, okay, this is the liver, this is the lungs, and this is the spleen, and this is the small intestine, large intestine, so many vital organs. So vital organs, inside that vital organs, that is the physical organ, inside that physical organ, there is a vital organ. Vital organ are the quantum field. Because how I am feeling within, the same it affects on my physical organs also. So he explained beautifully that the quantum field of the vital energy, it affects on our physical area also. So that vital energy totally affects on our physical organs. Like he has given the P organ and the V organ. So he used one word, the liturgic fields and the morphogenetic fields. So morphogenetic fields is like he has given example, that if we take birth from the one cell embryo, and after that it is the cells, they are dividing and dividing and dividing, and different organs are made. And different organs are made, and after that, it becomes the whole body. So it becomes the whole body means the physical organs and physical body. And inside that, the liturgic field says something that the physical organs does some function inside the body. So if we have the not good feelings with the relationship or any problem, so the same feelings affects in our vital organs also. So vital field. So it affects our functions also. So that's why he also prefers that you every day we should do meditation, we should do the pranayam, we should do the some practices, dubi. Like he has given very beautifully that about the what is the meaning of dubi and some exercises also. In his book, The Quantum Spirituality, he explained that the fundamental creativity and main is the situational creativity. Sometimes in this book also he has explained like if we have the problems and we have the so many feelings and so many thinkings and so many having the intuitions also, but how to choose? So he has given example that okay, it is the first you take the chance for the situational creativity. Situational creativity means that in the house we have the 4 or 5 family members, so you have to choose out of this that how I can improve my situation within that situational area. That is the situational creativity. Like if you choose one exercise every day and you do this exercise and you just see that what is the effect now it is coming on my vital body. Is it I'm clearing my all chakras? So he has explained about all the chakra system. Like for example, he has taken, he has given one example. Like his wife said, that okay, you say that I love you. So his wife said that okay, you prove it. How you love me? So he was stuck up in that question of his wife. So he has started like discovering how I can prove that I love her. So he started that which chakras is affected with the love. So he, like we say that in Ayurveda and in simple spirituality, we say that, okay, Anahat Chakra or the heart chakra is the love chakra because we open our heart and we love. But he said that he explained that the thymus gland is the love chakra or the heart chakra. Why he has given this example? That because he said that like the immune system, he has taken the example of immune system. In immune system, like if there is a foreign body, so our antibodies, they do not accept the foreign bodies, so they kill them. So if I am not accepting my partner, if I am not accepting my son, if I am not accepting my other family members, so my heart squeeze or my thymus gland squeeze or my immunity will not respond me, because immunity is something you add up in the me, because he has shown the pictures also. Like me is something, me and my husband, me and my wife, me and my daughter, me and my son, or me is my family. So like he said that okay, so thymus gland, like he has given the example like ki immune system, if you are not fell ill, if your heart pumping well and your skin luster is well, so you definitely you love with your partner. So he has given these type of like the quantum energy and he explained ki like non-locality word is very popular in this book. No locality is something, for example, if I am looking one plant in front of me and that plant has very good flower, So I'm directly connected with that flower. So I'm locally, I'm not moving to that, reaching that flower, and I'm connecting with it. The no local area, the known locality. He explained known locality is beyond the time and the space. Because if I'm looking that flower and I'm connected with that flower, and inside me, I'm feeling the pleasure and the happiness and the wellness to see that flower. So he said that known locality area is our the soul area, because directly I'm connected with that flower and without any time and the space. So that word also he has used in this vital body, that is the known locality. Sometimes we are sitting like two partners or two friends are sitting, and without any saying a word, we are connected with each other. We can't say anything. So he explained this is the quantum field, that is the known local area. We connected with each other. And we connected with each other, even he has given the example that like the some orbits and the electrons are moving, and the electrons, if they shift one orbit to the another orbit, so that electrons are not needed any space and the area, directly they jump. So he has given these type of examples, the same, like if we sit in the meditation and some the channeling is started, so there is no need of any local things. No need of local thing. This is the quantum energy. And I'm remembering one thing. Yesterday I was sitting in the meditation because I knew that today is my session. So the same, the quantum energy, immediately I connected with the higher world, the invisible world. So what is this? This is the quantum energy. So quantum energy is something when you are known locally, you are connected with the higher world. So in the same way, we can connect with our family members also. We can connect it with our society also. So this is the area he explained, like in the vital body and different chakras. He has also given the example of navel chakras also. Navel chakras, he said that because in many physical problems, we see that the IBS syndrome, intestinal bowel syndrome, sometimes we are not happy with sometimes the constipation, sometimes the loose motions, because that area is related with the ego. So he explained the self, ego self. If we acquire the ego self, so automatically we are conditioned. He explained that if we are conditioned more and more conditioned, so our quantum field area is stuck up and our chakras are stuck up, and we have the problem from the vital body and transfer to the physical body and that is the area where the navel chakras, where the liver, pancreas, spleen and small intestine part is available there, and they are all stuck up. Because of that, quantum field is not in a proper way. So that's why we stuck up at the physical level and as well as the vital level. So he explained very beautifully. And then third is the mind layer or the mind body. And he explained that is what is the mind? The first question was in this book. And is the brain is the mind? So brain and mind, both things are one or different. So he explained that suppose I'm speaking and someone is listening. So other person that is listening, according to my sentences, he is like thinking in the brain, thinking in the mind, and then he is taking out the meanings out of that sentences according to his wisdom. So he explained that, okay, because many persons are listening and they take out the negative meanings, they take out the wrong meanings from that. So the problem is where is the problem? So he explained that in the mind body, mind is the quantum field. And the brain brain is the physical area and as well as the quantum field area also. Because the physical area, why? Because it is related with the physical body. But inside that the physical, there is a quantum field also. He has explained the neuronal circuits, the neuronal paths, and the whole nervous system. He explained that it is related with the vital body, and vital body and the mental body. Mental body gives the thinkings, and after that thinkings, whatever the meanings we take out from that thinking, then it imprints in the brain. So it is a like a chain system. It is again the tangled hierarchy, because he has also the given the example. Again, his wife and he has visited some place, a spiritual place, and they both together attended one workshop. And after that, it was a spiritual workshop, and they were so happy there. But at that time, they were new in the spirituality. And then again, they back and sit in the car, and they start doing fighting. So he said that, what is that? Because the brain patterns, because the thinking patterns, because the memory, we just left that memory for the 10 days. And before that, what happens at the home, again, we remember, we memorize the things. And then he has given the two things, the conditioning and the creativity. So conditioning is something, because we just see the things, we do the things, we come in the action, and we memorize the things, because whatever we take out the meaning from the mind, and that mind imprints in the brain, in the neuronal circuits, or the, we can say the negative emotions or the positive emotions, whatever it is. And that quantum field area, it imprints in our brain, and then we react according to that. So he says that the mind gives the thinking and the meanings, whatever we take out from that sentences, and it imprints on the brain. Or then it imprints on the brain, then it becomes our persona. It becomes our persona, it becomes our character, and it becomes our ego self. We acquire the ego self again and again, because we are thinking about that particular situation. And he explained also the me-centeredness. Me-centeredness is something that, about the ego self. He said that, okay, he has also given one very beautiful story. And then he used the word, the narcissism. Narcissism is something you are just happy with your appreciations. You want to listen your appreciations from everyone's side. But I don't want to appreciate anyone. So he has given the example, that is the me-centeredness. The ego self is always is the me-centeredness. So if the me-centeredness, if I'm having the ego self, the immune system cannot enhance. He explained very, very clearly. Because the quantum area, because the quantum field that in the mind, and that is the in the vital body, that quantum area, it connected with the known locality. Because again, he explained that it is the invisible area, it is the universal area, it is the quantum field, directly they are connected. There is no limitation like the physical body, like the liver has the size, and the heart has the size, and the lungs has the size. But at the internal four layers, they have no size, no area. That is unlimited, and the energy fields area, the quantum field. So this is the mind body. Inside that, we understand the what type of the, according to our wisdom, we take out the meanings from that, that we imprints in the brain, and according to that, we behave and we do actions. So, and this becomes our, if we are stuck up in the memory, and then it becomes the ego self. Now it is the next. Next layer is the fourth layer, that is the Vigyanmay Kosha, or it is the supramental layer. Supramental layer is something like our which creates our inner beauty. And he explained that the 9 type of our qualities. Archetypal qualities means it is like our intuition. Sometimes we are sitting with someone and that person has some problem. So if we are more prone towards the mind, so maybe we have the we may help or not. But if we have the intuition, we should help universally. If I have the insight within this, okay, no, this is, I want to help him. So this is the insight and intuition he explained. And he said, and it is my view also, we can't purchase and we can't buy the inner beauty from the outside. It is inherited. It is inherited. But we just suppress because of our conditioning behavior, because of our programmed behavior, or because of our me-centeredness, or because of our mind self or the ego self. Because of this, we just suppress our archetypal behavior. So he has explained in so many pages that 9 archetypal traits or the qualities we should inculcate within ourselves. Because he explained that it is already within. It is already we have the intuitions. It is already we have the insights. Because insights and intuitions are just close with the next layer, Anandamaya Kosha. That is the quantum self. They two layers are very close. Supramental layer and the quantum self. They are very close. These are the doors to the heaven, he has written. So these archetypal qualities we should inculcate. Like 9 archetypal qualities he has explained. First is the justice. So do we justice with our family? Do we justice with our office? Do we justice with ourselves? Do we justice with the society? So these archetypal qualities we should inculcate. Because beyond the mind, these are the higher needs. That's why we came into meditation. That's why we want to evolve our soul. So there are so many reasons, because we come through the so many lessons, everyday life, and we want to evolve our souls. We want to evolve ourselves. We want to enhance our qualities. And without knowing the 4th layer, like the Vijnanamaya Kosha, we can't inculcate archetypal qualities like justice and beauty, abundance, wholeness. Nowadays, the whole world is suffering from or fear from the COVID-19. So he explained that about the wholeness. Wholeness is something about you accept everyone, because everyone has the different qualities. Everyone has different life journeys, but even then we are not ready to accept because of the me-centeredness or because of the ego self. So ego self we should lift, or ego self is like the conditioning. We should drop out all the conditioning and we have to step up in the creative world. So he explained that the archetypal behavior or archetypal qualities. So he said that justice, truth. Truth is always absolute. Truth is not, we can't change truth. So astoma sadgamya, tamsoma jyotirgamya. He explained that from the darkness, from the ignorance of your sheath, you have to go towards the light of wisdom. So the archetypal behavior or the 4th layer is the like the beauty, because we are so me-centered and conditioned in the program. We have no time to see the nature. We have no time to love animals. We have no time to compassion surrounding our animals or the bird beings. So he explained each and everything in this book, how you can inculcate your archetypal behavior. Like given the example, like Swami Vivekananda, Mahavatar Baba, Guru Nanak Ji, Jesus Christ, they have all archetypal qualities, because that qualities already we have, but because of the conditioning behavior or because of our reincarnation life theory, we just suppressed these archetypal qualities. Because of this, we just forget that, okay, these are the archetypal qualities we have to inculcate. So this is also, he has given the practice do be again. Okay, we appreciate, we close our eyes and we appreciate, we just connected with the surroundings as a wholeness. Okay, the surrounding is the consciousness, is the ground of all the beings. So we have to feel the consciousness. And in archetypal behavior, he said that, okay, you become oneness again. That is the split. I have given the example like the consciousness is one, universal consciousness. If I am just tear it, it splits into two, subject and object. So always we are divided, like in the mind, sometimes in the mind, sometimes in the vital body, sometimes in the feelings, sometimes in the thinking. So many things we are divided and divided. But in archetypal behavior, if we inculcate, so again we are going to become one, the oneness. So oneness is from the fourth body, that is the archetypal body. Then is the next is the fifth body. The fifth body is the quantum self. Quantum self is something like if we are wrapped up in one cloth and that cloth we shut down, because that quantum self is something different from the ego self, and we acquire that ego self because of our habits, because of our, we develop the many characters, different personalities. He said that the tangled hierarchy is something in the present situation. Okay, I am listening or I am speaking and I am respecting other one also. But sometimes what we do that we memorize the things. Okay, I have fight with that person and we memorize, we imprints in the brain. And again, we are memorizing the things. We make the patterns in the whole neuronal circuits. And then we are suffering from the conditioning behavior. And then we can't reach till the quantum self. So the quantum self is the most beautiful layer. That is the Anandamaya Kosha, where we are not connected with any other layer. Just we are... Then again, I remember one thing also. So the question asked by one person that how we can explain the quantum self or how the archetypal behavior, like he has represented himself in one movie, What the Bleep Do We Know? He was the main in that. He has written that the quantum physics is the physics of the possibilities. The physics of the possibilities, again in the quantum self, the something is the unmanifested part of ourself. When we manifest through the physics of possibilities, that is, that possibilities are beyond the mind, beyond the space and the time. So we have to manifest so many unconscious sleeping possibilities within us. So then we can reach the quantum self. So this is the whole book, essence of the whole book. And I don't know how I explain, because 2 and 3 years back, I have gone through this book. And because of this, I experienced in my life also practically, because every day, one practice I do with meditation, along with the meditation, like they go for, they said that you chant Om. Okay, so 6 months continuously I chant Om, and through Om, that Om, it opens all the chakras. If I am like inside, I am humming sound like this, so it enhances the conscious area, and that we split in the subject and the object, it again becomes one. because that increases the ether element. The ether element is very important, because if we see the above, the sky is the ether element, and if we see the down, the earth element, and it is in the divided in different jivatma, in different beings. One is one plant, the plant kingdom, animal kingdom, birds kingdom, insect kingdom. There are so many kingdom. So the consciousness divides according to our choice. He has written that it is our choice, it is our possibilities, and again the possibility, it becomes the probability. How much I am probable to do the things? I am 50%, maybe I'm maybe 60%. Sometimes we are always dual. Okay, I go through this book or not? I go through this topic or not? So sometimes we are half-heartedly, we just represent ourselves. So he said that the quantum energy is something you have the full potential power. He has given the example, like full potential, if there is a rope on the hill and you, that is the potential energy, and you just push up that rope, and then it moves down, that is the kinetic energy. So I have the potential, but if nobody is pushing me, or if I'm not doing meditation, I'm not practicing anything, so that kinetic, that potential energy is not convert, will not convert into kinetic energy. So this is the whole, the see the world as a five-layered cake, and quantum science and quantum science of consciousness and its experiences. So many experiences we can take from our quantum self also. So the conditioning we should left, and the creativity we should like adopt. And thank you so much. Thank you, Kavita. Thank you, Suresh sir.
Thank you, madam. You explained in detail the five courses and which are visible and which are not visible, and how they act. In detail, you explained as if we read the entire book. Once again, thank you very much, madam.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Very insightful learnings today, madam. Thank you so much for sharing the wisdom. We talked about five layers: physical, vital, mental, supramental, and bliss, and how quantum physics plays a major role on our memory, our behavior, and our daily activities in our lives, and also different perspectives on consciousness, how quantum thinking opens many possibilities for a new understanding of creativity in anybody's life. We did discuss vital body can clear out channels via chakras. And we did talk about meditation, breathing exercises, physical exercises on a daily basis impact cause and effect on our vital body. And then known locality, which connects with our soul area, irrespective of time and space. Also how through quantum energy, one can connect with higher worlds, and how we can evolve our souls, enhance our qualities, and how all these are interconnected with quantum physics. That was a wonderful and great knowledge sharing. Much, much more gratitude to you, Sangeeta ji, for taking time from your busy life and sharing your wisdom with us. Thank you so much, Sangeeta ji.
Thank you.
And Sureshi, do you have anything else to question or anything else to discuss? Okay. So I just want to give a brief intro about Spiritual India Magazine. Spiritual India Magazine is provided by Pyramid Spiritual Societies Movement, and it's a bi-monthly English magazine. This is bringing to you spiritual science concepts shared by Patriji and other spiritual scientists across the world. It's a spiritual journal of meditation and spiritual science. Please subscribe and get your copy today. And also, please watch this video. Could you please play the video? that's about Spiritual India Magazine. And once again, thank you so much, Sangeeta ma'am. It was a pleasure talking to you, knowing you as a person. And you're a huge inspiration to achieve many more accolades in my life. And this is Kavita Patlola signing off from Austin, Texas. You all have a blessed day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Good to see you, Pallavi. Finally, we are seeing each other.
Yes. Hi.
Hey, Sheetal. This is Kavita. All the best. I know you rock.
She doesn't need any bets.
I
She's too good. Sorry.